Never back down, never what?
Never give up.
Never back down, never what?
Never give up.
I fucking loved her. God damn it. None of it was a lie, except my name. It was real, and I wanted it again.
If I'd known that, I would have fought for you.
What do you mean?
I would have fought for us. I mean, at prom and at the funeral. I mean, I would have been there for you through everything.
I thought you knew.
Mr. Darcy's house, also known as Chatsworth House. I took the train from London to Chesterfield, which took an hour and a half. Then I took a gorgeous bus ride through the countryside and saw the most beautiful cottages. I checked out the grounds around the house, and they were filled with all these sheep. I got around to exploring the house, which is absolutely massive. Immediately, I recognized this grand hall as where Elizabeth first entered. This house was built in 1687, with 25 plus rooms on view and 126 rooms total. I said hi to the veiled lady statue, and then I headed into the sculpture gallery and had my pondering Elizabeth Bennet moment. And of course, I had to see Darcy himself. The rest of the time, I spent wandering around the gardens. I also found the iconic steps where Elizabeth runs away from Mr. Darcy. I climbed up the hill and got a great view of the entire estate. And then I had a little Liz on top of the world moment before I left to go back to London.
Y'all, when he is so possessive over her that he literally takes a picture of them kissing, very violently kissing, okay? His hand is like on her throat, they're kissing. And he posts it on his Instagram for thousands and thousands of people to see, even though they haven't told a single person that they've been together. And not only that, but then he captions it off limits and tags her. Oh my God. Oh my God! Yo, and there's a scene where he says that he wants to watch her favorite movie with her and imagine her watching it for the first time. Oh my God, tears. Tears are coming down my eyes. He's literally psychotic. He's psychotic, and this is what I'm focusing on. Help me.
Books that I read in one sitting. The criteria for reading a book in one sitting, it has to have a really fast plot and it has to have really good and easy writing. So if that's what you're looking for, then this video is for you. Okay, let's get into it. Okay, not to beat a dead horse or anything, but we're going to talk about Lynn Painter again, specifically her YA stuff. These two I read in one sitting. And by one sitting, I mean like start to finish throughout the middle of the night. I sat my ass down and I read these books and I didn't do anything else or look at anyone else. And when I closed the book, I was like, oh, it's morning now. Like, that's what these books do to me, okay? They're so cute and perfect, and the plot is so fast. They're YA, obviously, so they're really quick to read. And these are, like, my favorites ever. I gave them both 5 stars. Okay, next we have Once Upon a Broken Heart and The Ballad of Never After by Stephanie Garber. I read both of these in one day. And not like both of them in the same day, but like both of them in their own day, you know? These are fantasy, but they're really light and easy fantasy. There's not a lot of world building, so that made the story really easy to just jump right on into. The plot moves so fast, the story never gets boring or drags on anywhere, and these are just like the cutest love stories. Jax is to die for. He's one of my favorite book boyfriends ever. You will love him if you read these. I highly recommend them, especially if you are just getting into fantasy. This is a really good place to start. Okay, another duology that I never ever talk about is It Happens One Summer and Hook, Line, and Sinker. I don't own It Happens One Summer, but I read these both in one day, and they're just like really quick and easy. Did I love them? No, but I didn't hate them. I actually have no idea what I rated them. I really did not love It Happened One Summer, but I really, really liked this one for some reason. I don't know why everyone loves the first one more than this one. I actually like this one a lot more. I think I gave these like 3.5 or something, but yeah, they're just like so fast. Something about them is just really addicting and I don't know why. Okay, I know everyone doesn't actually like Addicted to You, like the first one. They say it gets better as the series goes on, but I personally love, 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 love this one. And it just holds a really special place in my heart. I remember vividly sitting down and reading this and like in one sitting, opening it and closing it like 5 hours later. I recommend if you're reading this to really appreciate this book if you're starting this series, because meeting these characters for the first time is something I will never forget. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I read A Court of Thorns and Roses in one day also, and it kind of like confuses me when people say this is really slow, because I did not have that experience at all. I flew through ACOTAR and A Court of Mist and Fury in one day, like seriously blew through them faster than I've ever read anything before in my entire life. And there's like a little bit of world building, so it's kind of like impressive to me that I was able to do that. I love these books, they're so quick and easy. And again, I know that everyone talks about ACOTAR, but I really think you should read them if you're getting into fantasy. Okay, I can't believe I didn't mention this first, but the next is Love in Other Words. And this was the first book that I ever read front to back in one sitting. This is one of my favorite love stories ever. This and Beach Read are like the OGs for me, okay? Like, when someone like in my life asks me, what book should I read? I'm trying to get into reading. I'm like, okay, Beach Read and Love in Other Words. So those are the OGs. I'm gonna recommend them to every single human on this earth. Alternating timelines, and it's just the cutest thing ever, okay? So go read it. I read Trust of the Emerald Sea by Brandon Sanderson in one day, and that's just because this is the cutest, most amazing story ever. Oh my gosh, I wish this was like the it book of this year alongside Divine Arrivals and Fourth Wing. This should be up there, okay? This is just beautiful, and it's not a romance, but it's an adventure story. It's fantasy, and if you want to get into Brandon Sanderson, you should really, 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 really read this. This is one of my favorites. I gave it 4.75 stars. Tress is one of my favorite female protagonists written in a story ever. I just love her, and you should really read this, okay? Because I devoured it in one day. Every single book video I do, I'm just like itching to mention Magnolia Parks, and of course I had to mention it in this one too, because I did read this in one day. This was, if there's anything in this world that I want you to associate with me, it is this series. It is this book. I'm getting this whole entire book tattooed on my body. I'm not even kidding. I'm just gonna like cover all of my flesh with Jessa Hastings' words, because that's the least that she deserves for giving me the story and these characters. And I just like can't even talk about Magnolia Parks. Like I just get all flustered and like giggly, and I can't even. Let me know what tattoos I should get for this book, because I'm gonna get a tattoo dedicated to the series. I probably am gonna wait till after Into the Dark comes out, which yes, I did see that, and yes, I'm freaking out. I got like a DM from someone saying, oh my gosh, did you see that Into the Dark, like, that Jessa Hastings announced the title? And I was like, first of all, thank you for like thinking of me when that came out, because yes, I did see that, and yes, I cried myself to sleep because I'm so excited. Magnolia Parks, I read it in one day. Okay, those are all the books. Thank you for watching. Mwah.
It's like a reward.